So in this video, I try to beat Terraria how the developers intended it to be beaten. Some of you may not know this, but there is official guide Terraria handbooks that were published. And thanks to the help of some donators, I was able to get my hands on them. There's actually 4 handbooks, but the one I'm missing is just the one about building, and we don't really need that one to beat the game. So the first half of this playthrough is gonna consist of me using the first 2 handbooks, the Ultimate Survival one and the Exploration and Adventure one. Maybe towards the end of pre-hard mode, we might dabble into the third book, which is the hard mode one, but for now these 2 books are our guides. So we start off our playthrough by making a new world and new character. I will be playing Terraria 1.4, even though these books were made before 1.4 existed. I just wanted to play in the current updated version. The book says if it is your first time playing the game, play on softcore and normal settings. I'm not new to the game, but these are usually my go-to settings for playing Terraria casually. For the world size, I will be choosing medium for more chest loot potential. And the first 2 chapters of the survival handbook just list a bunch of basic information about character creation and controls, so we can skip them. Chapter 3 is where the game really begins. The handbook tells me to gather around 150 pieces of wood and then tells me to craft a wooden sword because it's time to hunt for some slimes. After I kill a slime or 2, the handbook tells me to clear an area out so we can start building a shelter. I'll try my best to copy the exact build from the handbook, but it might be off a little. And once I place the torches down, boom, our first house is good to go. So chapter 4 begins by telling us to get out and explore. It also tells us to check any caves nearby to find some chest loot. The handbook then tells me to craft some platforms, grab some mushrooms, and find some ropes. As we venture into our first real cave, the handbook tells me to mine all the copper or tin and iron or lead I could find. So after a brief mining adventure, chapter 5 of the handbook tells me to return home and start setting up basic crafting stations. So after making those basic crafting stations, the handbook talks a little about the other tiers of ores we can get our hands on. So I'm gonna take a little trip to the caves to get a full set of any ore armor. Chapter 6 of the handbook is about building. The handbook wants me to set up a nice little home for myself using the hammer to create some nice slopes for the roof. The handbook also tells me to start setting up some minecarts for fast transit around the area. This is usually something I don't do myself, especially since 1.4 adds in pylons for fast travel, but for the sake of the handbook, I'll do it. The handbook then wants me to craft and set up a bed for my own personal room. Then it tells me to create a couple more houses for NPCs. The book says to craft some builder potions to help speed up the process. Chapter 7 is very brief and just talks about all the NPCs we can encounter in pre-hard mode, so this chapter we can skip over. Moving on to chapter 8 though, the handbook says to make sure that I have the best gear that I can get my hands on at this current time. It also brings up to make sure that I have a decent stock of potions and food whenever I can get my hands on them. The handbook then starts to talk about all the bosses we can encounter in pre-hard mode, so this is where I decide that we should finally take on the first boss, the King Slime. After easily defeating the King Slime, the book says to take on the Eye Cthulhu with at least silver or tungsten armor and a decent ranged weapon. It also says if you have just your arrows, use them for this fight. For the next part of this video, we're going to take a look into the next book, because we're basically done with the first one. All the info we need from the first one at this point is the bosses, which is at the very end of that book. The second book has a lot of good info about all biomes and loot that you can find from those biomes. It even includes all the enemies that can spawn and the loot that they drop. I'll be honest, if you don't have access to the Terraria Wiki, these books are a great alternative. So there is a very important section in this book called the Exploration Order section. This right here will really be our progression guide for the rest of pre-hard mode. As you can see, we're kind of at the third part of this section, aka the Defeat the Corruption or Crimson section. At this point, I'm going to skip to the Crimson section of the book and try and use any tips it lists there. The book says to make sure I have at least silver or tungsten armor before we dive into the Crimson. It then lists multiple ways we can break the Crimson hearts, either with bombs and dynamite or by using purification powder and mining the now purified stone. With this information told to us, I think it's time to take on the Brain of Cthulhu. With the Brain of Cthulhu defeated, I should mention that I did explore a bunch of the underground snow biome before the fight because I decided that it would be the best place to get some extra loot before taking on the Brain. So referring back to the Exploration Order, the fourth part says to master the dungeon. So that means we have to take on Skeletron. Before taking on Skeletron, I want to explore a bit of the underground desert to try and get my hands on some more loot. On top of that, I have upgraded most of my gear to the Crimson tier equipment. I will slide this in here. I don't usually take on Skeletron after the Brain or the Eater. I usually tackle the underground jungle and the Queen Bee, but since I'm following the handbook's progression, Skeletron will be defeated first. After defeating Skeletron, it is time to explore the dungeon. The handbook brings up all the usual information on the dungeon, which includes the enemies that spawn and the loot that we can get. One of the pieces of loot that sticks out in the handbook is the water bolt, so I made it a goal to get my hands on one. The book also brings up to get my hands on an obsidian shield when I can, so we'll keep that in mind for the future. After looting the dungeon, it is time to hit up the underground jungle. The book says to have shadow or crimson armor equipped before visiting. The book mentions we could craft some powerful items such as a thorn chakram, blade of grass, and Amazon yo-yo, so I decided to make it a goal to grab all three of those. Before we take on the queen bee, the book suggests to fish up some honeyfish, which are one of the best pre-hard mode healing items we can get our hands on. With these new weapons and healing potions in hand, it's time to take on the queen bee. After we defeat a couple of the queen bees, I decide it's time to mine a little bit of meteorite for a tool upgrade. It is finally almost time to take on the wall of flesh. Let's refer to part 5 of the exploration order, which says to head to the underworld and get our hands on hellstone and molten armor. Before we go ahead and do that, I decide to skim around the rest of the second handbook just to see if there's any other things it wants us to go out of our way and do. Because after the wall of flesh, it will be time for us to check out the hard mode handbook. The only other useful information that isn't hard mode or wall of flesh related is the fishing information. The fishing guide doesn't tell me to go out of my way to get anything specific, but I will try and get the fuzzy carrot from quest because I have been needing a better mount. With that done, it's finally time to take on the wall of flesh. The book says to make sure that I have all of the best weapons, armors, and items that I can get my hands on. And with the wall of flesh finally defeated, we can move on to the hard mode handbook. So the first chapter of the hard mode handbook is just a bunch of overall information of what hard mode is. Nothing we really need to pay attention to here, so we can skip this chapter. Chapter 2 might be our biggest to-do list from the handbook so far. There's a whole hard mode preparation checklist that we need to do. Obviously, this list looks like it was meant to be done before hard mode, but given that it's in the second chapter of the hard mode labeled book, we'll let it pass for now. So let's get to knocking these lists out. Let's start off with the construction projects. We have a elevator and we have a boss arena, so those two are done. The only one we need to do is upgrade our base's defense. For this, I will be adding some one-way entrances for myself, that way monsters can't get in and the NPCs can't get out. I will also add some shallow lava pits here and there. Next up is crafting projects. Most of these I've completed except for a few select ones. I need to upgrade my flint staff to an imp staff, and I need to combine a bunch of accessories. With those done, let's move on to the next list, which is useful items. This list is very basic. We pretty much have it completed already. So on to the next one. The only ones I need to do on this list is create a surface mushroom biome, fish for some crates, and craft a heart lantern. Boom, with all those completed, let's move on. Chapter 3 is called Unlocking Hard Mode. We kind of did this already. This whole chapter is just about fighting the wall of flesh. We can skip this one. The beginning of chapter 4 talks about getting our hands on some hard mode ores. It only mentions the first two tiers of hard mode ores, not adamantium or titanium, so I guess we won't be touching those yet. The next part of chapter 3 talks about upgrading a couple of weapons. The two weapons that stand out are the chick and the golden shower, so let's get our hands on those. After that, it's time to get some wings. The book lists either angel or demon wings, so I snagged some demon ones. Before we move into chapter 5, I decide it's time to take on our first mech boss. Quickly, let me upgrade my armor to titanium and we should be ready to go. I should mention that I am leaning towards being a mage in this run, but I will still follow what the book says to grab, even if it's for other classes. With the destroyer defeated, the book mentions to craft a mega shard, and with that crafted, let's move on to chapter 5. Chapter 5 is a very simple chapter. It just talks about the NPCs we can find in hardwood. It does actually have a checklist, but obviously we can't do it all at once without killing a couple of bosses and completing some events. I will try my best to get the NPCs that are available right now though. Chapter 6 is about hard mode crafting stations. This is another chapter we really don't have to worry too much about. I should insert here that I am going to take on the pirate invasion though. Chapter 7 is called Hard Mode Bosses. This is where the action is really about to step up. Since this is an older book, the Queen Slime obviously isn't in here. I'm still going to fight her really quick before we take on the next two mech bosses. With the Queen Slime dead, let's take on the Twins and Skeletron Prime. With every single mech boss defeated, we can now craft some hollowed equipment, which will be a major upgrade for us. The book does also mention to craft the optic staff after killing the twins. Next up is Plantera and the Golem. For Plantera, the book recommends to get our hands on some full set of chlorified armor and weapons. After Plantera is dead, we move on to the Jungle Temple. The Golem has always been an easy fight, so this should be no problem. With the Golem defeated, it's time to look forward towards the Duke. Before the fight, I get my hands on the best gear that I can and then defeat the Duke. Chapter 8 is all about hard mode events. The first event on the list is the Frost Legion. I usually don't do this event due to it being seasonal, but let's do it anyways. Christmas is right around the corner, so it won't be that bad to do it. With the Snow Legion defeated and zero new pieces of loot in my inventory because it's one of the worst, most overlooked events in Terraria, we move on to the next event in the book, which is the Solar Eclipse. After that, we take on the Martian Madness event. During this event, I get my hands on the laser machine gun, which is a great weapon. Next up is the big boy events, aka the Pumpkin Moon and the Frost Moon. There's a couple of weapons that I want from these events, but if I don't get them during this, then oh well. Chapter 9 is probably one of the shortest chapters out of all three books. It just talks about the Jungle Temple and the Hard Mode Dungeon. The only thing it mentions is taking some traps from the Jungle Temple to improve our home defenses. After that's done, we're on to the next chapter. Chapter 10 is called the Lunar Event. The book recommends to get the Cosmic Car Key mount, so I made sure to grab one. With that said, let's take on the Lunatic Cultists. With the cultists defeated, I take on 3 out of 4 pillars, mainly the Nebula one, so I can have some more weapon upgrades before the Moon Lord. With the final pillar defeated, it is time for Chapter 11, the Moon Lord. With the Moon Lord defeated, we get our hands on a hero's reward and end our developer intended adventure. This was a very fun video to create. Usually when people play Terraria, they have a very specific path and meta they follow, and by me following the book, I had to do some things very different from what I usually do. Keep in mind that these handbooks aren't exactly perfect guides for a playthrough of the game. They do give out tips here and there and have fun little facts, but I still believe the Terraria Wiki is probably the better guide. With that said, I do hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to leave a like and to subscribe if you enjoyed the content. Also, let me know if you want to see a part 2 with either me following the Terraria Wiki guides, or if you want me to buy the crafting and construction handbook and to build how the developer intended. Anyways, I'll see y'all next time.